Así que estamos en su presencia.
So tonight we're in his presence.
Y estaba ahorita con mi esposa.
And I was speaking to my wife,
conversing with her. Como las cosas del Señor siempre.
And we were having, you know, one of our spiritual conversations.
Y nos sonaba el oído el Salmo 100.
And Psalms 100 was the one that was ringing into our ears.
Versículos 4 y 5.
Verse 4 and 5.
Entrad por sus puertas con acción de gracia, por sus atrios con alabanza, alabre, bendice su nombre.
Psalms 100 verse 4 and 5 says, enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful to him and bless his name, for the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures to all generations.
Porque Jehová es bueno y para siempre su misericordia. Y su verdad por todas las generaciones.
Amen.
For the Lord is good and his mercy is everlasting and his truth endures to all generations.
Por todas las generaciones Dios es bueno.
For all generations.
Diga,
God
repite
is good.
Conmigo, Dios es bueno.
God is good.
Dios es bueno.
Dios es
God
bueno.
Is good.
Y para siempre su misericordia.
And forever is his mercy.
Vamos a orar, Padre.
Father,
en el nombre de Jesús,
in your name,
entregamos este servicio,
we present this service to you,
a tu presencia,
in your presence,
para alabarte y bendecir tu nombre,
to worship and bless your name.
Toma control del predicador,
take control of the speaker tonight,
de los alabanza,
of the worshipers,
el traductor,
of the translator,
los maestros,
of the teachers,
los ujieres,
of the ushers,
y todos los que te sirven, Señor,
and every person who's here tonight,
sean sirviendo en excelencia hacia ti, Señor,
that we continue to serve you in excellence, oh Lord,
que sea un servicio no igual que otro corriente, Señor,
that this service is not just like any other,
que tu palabra venga y separe el bien del mal,
that your word will come to us and bless us.
Gracias, Señor.
Thank you, oh Lord,
por todas las cosas maravillosas,
for all the amazing things
que estás haciendo y seguirás haciendo,
and you continue to do.
Porque tú eres el mismo ayer, hoy y para siempre.
Because you're the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Te damos gracias en el nombre de Jesús.
And we thank you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Aleluya.
Aleluya.
Tenemos un Dios grande y poderoso. ¿Cuántos lo saben?
We have a powerful, almighty Lord.
Damos gracias al Señor porque ya estamos escuchando noticias de personas que están saliendo del hospital.
We're super grateful because we continue to hear the news of the people that continue to recover and come back to the church.
Ya hoy tuvimos a los pastores Joaquín y Beth de regreso en casa.
And we know that the pastor and his family is also coming back to the home.
Y seguimos orando por Pastor Richie, la Pastora Angie, para que pronto estén muy bien y puedan regresar acá con nosotros.
And we continue to pray for Pastor Richie and his wife Angie that will continue to recover and please and will soon will join us.
Así que damos gracias a Dios porque Él es bueno y podemos tener este tiempo para alabarlo a Él. Amén.
And we are so grateful and thankful that we have this time to worship Him tonight.
Como cristianos tenemos herramientas y la alabanza es una herramienta poderosa para tú levantarte en fe en contra del enemigo y todo lo que Él ha dicho para ti.
And God has given us amazing tools and skills, and the worship tonight is one of those skills that God gives, that God has given us to worship His name and praise Him.
Porque cuando estás alabando, tú quitas el enfoque de ti y te enfocas en Dios.
So I ask you tonight not to focus on the worshiper, but to actually focus on the Lord.
Así que vamos a alabar al Señor ahora con todas nuestras fuerzas.
So let's pray the Lord tonight with all our strength.
Él es el poderoso de Israel.
He is the mighty of Israel.
Él es el que pelea tus batallas.
He is the one that fights your battles.
Dios maravilloso.
God is almighty.
Grande y digno de alabar.
He's huge and worthy of all praise.
Vamos
Amen.
A alabarlo. Aleluya.
Let's pray the Lord.
Cuando veas sus rodillos, tu pueblo lo alabará.
Señor, tu nombre es grande.
Oh Lord, your name is big.
Y hemos conocido, Dios, que eres un Dios poderoso.
And we have to know how powerful is our God.
Y cada historia narrada en tu libro, en la Biblia, sabemos que es real, Señor.
Every story that is narrated in the Bible, through history, you know it's true.
Y no están allí solamente para tú y yo escuchar historias y ser entretenidos por ellas.
And this is not only there for you and I to hear and just know about it.
Sino para mostrarte quién es nuestro Dios, el Dios en quien tú y yo creemos.
And also just to actually show and demonstrate that you are powerful, God.
Ese mismo Dios que abrió el mar es el que aún hoy sigue abriendo sendas donde no hay.
It's the same God that opened the waters of the Red Sea. He continues to open miracle ways today.
Él es el dulce refugio en medio de tu tormenta.
You are the God that protects us and continue to do it every single day.
Gracias, Señor, porque no tenemos a quién ir, a quién acudir, solamente en ti, en Encontramos refugio verdadero, Señor.
Thank you, Lord, because it's only in you that we can find our protection.
Cuando todo parece difícil, imposible, nuestra carga de llevar.
When everything in front of us seems to be difficult and impossible.
Nosotros podemos encontrar descanso verdadero en ti, Señor.
It's only in you that we can find rest.
Podemos encontrar paz y certeza.
We can find peace.
De que si tú estás con nosotros, todo va a estar bien, Señor.
And we also know that because of you and you are with us, that everything is going to be all right.
Vamos a declarar en esta hora, Señor, tú eres el aire que yo respiro, tú eres el pan que yo necesito cada día, tú eres todo para mí.
Let's sing to the Lord that he is our earth, he is our breath, he is our bread that we need for every single day of our lives.
Hazle este canto tu oración al Señor.
Let's sing this song to the Lord with all your strength.
Your whole quiero es adorarte. Lo único que quiero es adorarte. Vengo a tus pies para entregar mi corazón. Lo único que quiero es agradarte. Lo único que quiero es agradarte. Por siempre cantaré de tu amor. Gracias, Señor, por la libertad que nos has dado en Cristo.
We thank you, Lord, for the nurturing of our spirit.
Por la libertad para poder adorarte, Señor.
For the freedom that you have given us so we can speak to you.
Ya no hay cadenas que nos aten al pecado o a nuestro pasado, Señor.
There are no chains that will hold us down, hold us back because of our sins and our past.
Tu muerte en la cruz y resurrección y el derramamiento de tu sangre nos ha hecho libres, oh Dios.
Your death in the cross, but your resurrections that make us free. We have defeated death through your bloodshed.
Ayúdanos, Dios, a caminar en esa libertad.
Help us to walk in that freedom that you have given us.
Y nunca menospreciar, Señor,
to
la
never
sangre,
take it for granted.
Esa sangre derramada que nos dio libertad.
That blood that was shed and has given us freedom.
Que rompió el velo para hoy poder entrar en tu misma presencia.
That tear down the veil in the temple, and for that we have direct connection with your presence.
Simplemente adorarte.
And just to be able to speak to you.
Exaltar tu nombre, Señor.
To glorify your name.
Callar todas las voces en nuestra vida solamente da lugar a ti.
To silence all those other voices in our minds and our lives and only listen to yours.
Porque solamente tú eres importante, Señor.
Because only your voice is important for us.
Lo único que quiero es adorarte. Lo único que quiero es adorarte. Vengo a tus pies para entregar mi corazón. Lo único que quiero es agradarte, lo único que quiero es agradarte, por siempre cantaré de tu amor. ¿Cuántos tienen el amor de Dios? Lo único que quiero es adorarte, lo único que quiero es adorarte, vengo a tus pies para entregar mi corazón. Gracias, Señor, por este tiempo en tu presencia. Gracias porque sabemos que te vas a seguir moviendo en este lugar.
Thank you for this time in your presence, and thank you for you continue to move, and your Holy Spirit continues to bless us and anoint us tonight.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Gloria al Señor. Pueden sentarse, hermanos. Estás en tu casa.
Please be seated. You are in your house, in your home tonight.
Si ustedes están en su casa, pero si usted está en su casa.
Well, if you are at home and you're watching us online,
queremos darle la bienvenida como si estuvieran acá.
We want to welcome you like you are here with us tonight.
Pues somos un solo cuerpo.
As well, one body.
Y aunque ahora mismo el cuerpo está en sus casas y separados.
And we know that either the body right now seems to be a little bit separated, and some of us are here, some of others are watching online.
Realmente estamos unidos por el mismo espíritu.
We're actually united through the same spirit.
Y a través de la sangre de la cual acabamos de cantar, amen.
And through the blood of which one we have worship and talk about tonight.
Así que hoy tenemos un predicador especial con nosotros.
So tonight we have a very, very special preacher.
Y sé que va a ser tremenda bendición para todo el cuerpo de Cristo.
And we know it's going to be a tremendous blessing for the whole body of Christ.
Pero antes queremos recordarles algunos anuncios.
But before, we have a couple of announcements that we have for you.
El lunes tenemos el Club del Libro. No estoy seguro si está funcionando, ¿sí?
Tomorrow night, we're still having the book club.
Okay. Estén atentos por Facebook porque la pastora Angie va a avisar si mañana van a tener el club del libro.
So continue to be connected through our Facebook page because Pastor Angie will be letting us know the status of the book club tomorrow night.
Así mismo. Así que el miércoles tenemos acá nuestro servicio en la noche.
So on Wednesday we have a midweek service at 7 o'clock at night.
Jueves servicio de oración en
Thursday,
Facebook.
Thursday our praying service.
Acá en el templo
right here
y en
church,
Facebook también.
And on Facebook.
Así que usted puede escoger. Y también vamos a estar al tanto si va a hacerlo en Facebook el jueves.
And also we'll continue to keep an eye on our status on Facebook.
Y el viernes y sábado los programas de los jóvenes más pequeños, el sábado de los jóvenes universitarios.
And our youth continues to gather here on Fridays, and also the oldest, the Living Stones, will gather on Saturdays.
Y próximo domingo a las 9 en inglés, 12 en español. Y hay algo diferente el próximo domingo, estoy seguro que luego se va a anunciar con mayor precisión.
And next Sunday we have a very special Sunday because we're going to be meeting at the morning service at 9 o'clock, but then at noon we'll be heading to the 888 with Bishop Boone.
Así que exactamente a las 9 nos vamos a reunir acá para el servicio en inglés, pero a las 12 vamos a estar en Trump Doral, que ahí va a ser un servicio bien especial con el Pastor Boone. 8 horas, él ha estado promocionando esto por un buen tiempo ya.
So we want to make sure that you understand how the program is going to run next Sunday. So at 9 o'clock in the morning next Sunday, we're going to have our service, English service. And then at noon, we're going to move to the Trump International down just down the street, where we're going to be there for a continued 8 hours with Bishop Boone and an amazing event that we have prepared for you that we call it 888.
Amen. Y también la próxima semana, lunes, el evento va a ser allá también. Creo que el martes hay algo también, el miércoles. Así que estén atentos para más detalle en cuanto a la próxima semana.
So there's a lot of events that we have planned and scheduled over the next couple of days. So continue to pay attention to our updates in our Facebook page and online.
Así que conéctese, muchas oportunidades para recibir, pero también para dar.
With this, we also know that there is plenty of opportunities for you to receive, but also to serve.
Así que no sea solamente de los que reciben, sino que busque un ministerio donde usted pueda servir y pueda también dar de lo que Dios le da a usted.
Amen. So pay attention because this, you know, it's good that every single one of us get linked with a ministry that you can also not just receive, but be able to serve and give back to the Lord and amazing blessings that He has given us.
Así que sin más, vamos a recibir a Pastor Juan por segunda vez acá con nosotros.
So without further ado, please, let's receive Pastor
Una palabra
Juan
del Señor.
That is with us tonight.
Gloria a Dios, aleluya.
Aleluya.
Buenas tardes.
Good evening, everyone.
Dios les continúe bendiciendo.
May God continue to bless every single one of you tonight.
Estamos súper animados, estamos viendo respuesta de las oraciones.
We are super encouraged and motivated because we continue to see answers to our prayers. Every single day we receive updates of what's going on.
Bueno, Pastor Richie me llamó el viernes.
So Pastor Richie gave me a call on Friday, last Friday.
Me dice que está mejorando.
He says that he's actually getting better, improving every
pero,
day.
pero necesita unos días más para recuperarse.
But he needs another couple of days to rest and recover fully and get back.
Confiemos en el Señor que va a terminar la obra y poderlo tener aquí en casa.
We continue to trust in the Lord that he will finish the work that he has begun, and very soon Pastor Richie and Angie, both of them will be back with us serving 100%.
Bueno, vamos a orar para que el Señor sea obrando y que yo sea un instrumento en el cual la palabra llegue a cada uno de ustedes. Amén.
So let's pray tonight and just continue to trust the Lord, and the Lord is going to be the one doing the work and will continue to bless us.
Padre, te damos gracias en el nombre de Jesús.
Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus.
Gracias por este día, gracias por tu presencia.
Thank you for this day and thank you for your presence.
Gracias por cada uno de los que están y los que están viendo por internet.
Thank you for all of those that are able to make it here tonight presentially, and also for those who are watching online.
Que esta palabra no retorne vacía, como dice tu palabra.
That this word will never turn back void.
Te pedimos, Señor, que sea martillo cual parte la piedra.
That this becomes a hammer that will slash through the stone.
Te damos gracias porque es un privilegio estar aquí.
We thank you because it's a tremendous privilege for here to be here tonight.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Amén.
Amen, amen.
Bueno, el Señor me inquietó y titulé la prédica, Déjate guiar por Dios.
So what God put in my heart was to prepare a sermon tonight that I have titled it, Let God Be the One Who Leads You.
Entonces, meditando en el Señor, orándole a Dios, y él me dio un ejemplo para que podamos entender lo que quiero expresar aquí esta noche.
So, while I was praying and preparing for this service tonight, God gave me an example that I want to use, an analogy that I want to use for you, so you can understand what are we talking about here tonight.
Para poder nosotros dejarnos usar de Dios, tenemos que escuchar a Dios.
So, for us to be able to be used by God, we have to listen to God.
Uno del ejemplo es, muchas veces las madres están en un sitio y sus niños están en otro sitio.
So many times we see that there's mothers and children, and their mothers are in one place and their children are far away in another place.
Y entonces una madre dice, está llorando el niño.
And one of the moms will say, the kid is crying.
Y hay 20 niños gritando.
And there's 20 kids crying or yelling and screaming.
Porque ella es sensible a la voz de su hijo.
But she's sensitive to that specific cry of her children.
La madre va al sitio.
So mom moves to where the children is.
Si no está llorando, está en el problema.
And if it happens that he's not crying, he or she's not crying, she knows that the kid is in trouble.
Así es Dios.
And
Dios,
God is just like that.
Dios identifica nuestra voz.
God identifies our voice.
Dios sabe qué es lo que necesitamos.
God knows what is that we need.
Pero tenemos que saber hacerlo. Amen.
But we need to be able to listen to his word and be sensitive to it.
Vamos a Primera de Samuel 16 a partir del versículo 1.
So let's go to 1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 1.
Y dijo el Señor a Samuel, ¿hasta cuándo llorarás a Saúl, habiéndolo yo desechado para que no reine sobre Israel? Llena tu cuerno de aceite y ven, te enviaré a Isaí de Belén, porque de sus hijos me he provisto de rey.
1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 1 says, Now the Lord said to Samuel, How long will you mourn for Saul, seeing I have rejected him from reigning over Israel? Fill your horn with oil and go. I am sending you to Jesse the Bethlehemite, for I have provided myself a king among his sons.
Entonces podemos ver allí en este versículo que había una lucha en la mente de Samuel.
So here in this verse we can see there is a battle, a fight going on in the mind of Samuel.
Él estaba llorando.
He was crying.
Por Saúl.
For Saul, King Saul.
Entonces, que muchas veces a nosotros nos pasa que estamos en esa lucha, Dios quiere hablarnos, Dios quiere que actuemos, pero estamos pensando en lo que está atrás.
So many times we find ourselves in this situation where we just have our minds are occupied with, you know, this internal ongoing battle, and we continue to look backwards to what is in the past.
Entonces, en esa lucha, Dios interviene y le dice, ¿por qué estás llorando? Deja de llorar.
And while Samuel is going through this battle, God intervenes, and it's very clearly when he tells Samuel, what is that you're, you know, that you're looking backwards?
Entonces, vamos al segundo versículo.
Let's go to the next verse 2.
Y dijo Samuel, ¿cómo iré? Si Saúl lo supiera, me mataría. El Señor respondió, toma contigo una becerra de la vacada y di a ofrecer sacrificio al Señor, he venido.
Verse 2 says, And Samuel said, "How can I go? If Saul hears it, he will kill me." But the Lord said, "Take a heifer with you and say, 'I have come to sacrifice to the Lord.'"
Cuando suceden este tipo de cosas,
when these things take place,
nosotros estamos pensando en algo que pasó en algo de atrás.
So when these things take place, we sometimes tend to be focused on what's in the past, what already taken place.
Ya eso está desechado por parte de Dios. Dios está preparando algo mejor hacia adelante y nosotros seguimos pensando en lo que está sucediendo o lo que sucedió atrás.
But we fail to understand that what God is doing is preparing us for what is to come, but we make the mistake that we continue looking backwards.
Le voy a dar un ejemplo.
Let me give you an example.
Estamos allá en Venezuela haciendo oración en las mañanas.
So we were back home in our country of Venezuela praying in the morning.
Entonces un hermano me dice, vamos a orar por algo específico.
And one of the brothers there tells me, "Hey, I want to pray for something very specific."
Entonces el hermano empieza a orar pidiendo perdón, teniendo en cuenta que él tenía la culpa de lo que había sucedido.
So he starts praying and he's actually repenting for very, very clearly about something that has happened and he felt that he was guilty of.
Se quebranta.
He was broken.
Y bueno, termina el servicio de oración.
And then the prayer service ended.
El siguiente día.
Next day.
El hermano sigue orando.
The brother continues to pray.
Por lo mismo.
For the same thing.
Se quebranta.
He's broken again.
Se echa la culpa.
He feels that he's ashamed. He feels guilt.
Y se lamenta de todo lo que había sucedido.
And he continues to lament about all these things that happened already in the past, but there in the past.
Yo no le dije nada.
And I just didn't say anything. I remained quiet.
Yo le dije, voy a esperar el siguiente día.
And I decided to wait until the next day.
Venimos el tercer día.
We come back on the third day.
Y hermano vuelve a orar.
And our brother comes and prays again.
Y sigue diciendo que él tiene la culpa de lo que acaba de pasar y toda la cuestión.
And he continues to repeat the same thing, that he feels guilty of what has taken place, and he feels broken and just ashamed.
Yo le dije, avanza.
And I told him, hey, you need to move on.
El Señor Jesús muchas veces dijo, tus pecados son perdonados, ve y no peque más.
Jesus told his disciples, listen, your sins have been forgiven. Move on and don't sin anymore.
Entonces muchas veces tenemos ese tipo de oración que oramos pidiendo perdón, oramos pidiendo perdón, oramos pidiendo perdón y no salimos a lo que Dios tiene para nosotros, que Dios nos está guiando a mirar hacia el frente.
So many times this happens to us as well, that we continue to pray and we repent and we pray and we repent and we pray and we repent and we fail to understand that Jesus has listened to our praise and he's already moving forward and has what is next for us.
Aquí me estoy recordando un ejemplo que la otra vez me dio un amigo pastor.
So I'm remembering an example that another friend of mine, pastor, gave me.
Tú vas manejando en el carro.
You're driving on your car.
El parabrisas.
And you see a windshield.
Es amplio.
It's huge, it's big.
El retrovisor es pequeño.
But the rear mirror is tiny, small.
Para ver qué viene atrás.
And you know, and the purpose of this is for you to only look for a small time what is coming behind you.
Pero tu mirada tiene que estar hacia adelante.
But the windshield is huge and it's for you to look forward. You see the big side in front of you.
Imagínate que vas en el expressway solamente mirando por el retrovisor.
So imagine yourself driving down the highway only looking at the rear mirror.
Nos vamos a estrellar.
You're going to crash.
Entonces, es más grande lo que Dios tiene aquí adelante de lo que pudo haber pasado.
So the example here is telling us that what we have ahead is way bigger than what is in our past.
Vamos al siguiente Amen. Versículo.
So let's go to the next verse.
Y llama Isaí al sacrificio, y yo te enseñaré lo que harás de hacer, y me ungirás al que yo te dijere.
Verse 3. Then invite Jesse to the sacrifice, and I will show you what you shall do. You shall anoint for me the one I name to you.
Entonces, yo voy a dividir hoy la palabra. Voy a ver, colocar lo que la actitud de Samuel y de otro personaje bíblico, cómo toma cuando Dios lo dirige.
So tonight, the idea that I have is I want to separate the reaction that Samuel is showing throughout this part of the word of the gospel verse, and I got to compare it with another character of the Bible here very soon.
Como estaba ahorita diciendo el hermano Josué, hay muchas áreas en la iglesia que nosotros podemos servir.
So yeah, as our brother Joshua was saying, there's plenty of different ministries we can serve at church.
Pero a veces no servimos porque no viene alguien y te dice, mira, ve y agarra y recoge la silla.
But sometimes we choose not to serve because someone hasn't come to you and say, hey, come and do so and so.
O venimos de otra iglesia.
Or we come from another church.
Y o teníamos un liderazgo.
And we used to have a leadership role in that church.
O alguien lo hirió y no quiere pasar esa página.
Or something, you know, something actually happened and you're just not ready yet to move forward.
O se va alguien de la iglesia.
Or maybe someone left church.
Te causa un dolor.
It hurts you.
Pero eso no te tiene que paralizar.
But that doesn't mean that you have to stop.
Yo voy a contar el testimonio cuando yo llegué aquí a Estados Unidos.
So I want to share with you my testimony when I first came to the United States.
El Señor en Venezuela me da una palabra para yo venir aquí a Estados Unidos.
God spoke to me, so and he told me to move on and come to the United States.
Entonces con el pastor Alexis, allá en Venezuela, ubicamos al pastor Joaquín.
So my pastor there, Pastor Alexis, we put Pastor Joaquín and Pastor Alexis in touch back and forth.
Entonces entro en comunicación con él y él me dice, sí, vente, yo te voy a recibir aquí en la iglesia, me dice el Pastor Joaquín.
So Pastor Joaquín accepted me to come to the United States and he said, please come and I will welcome you here at Spring of Life.
Y bueno, ustedes saben cómo fue la bienvenida, no la tengo que decir, amén.
Well, you know exactly how that went and how it happened, and we're here.
Okay, entonces, estando aquí, la vida del inmigrante es un poco fuerte.
And being here, the immigrant's life, you know, how I learned, is pretty tough.
Y venían pensamientos de decir, voy a irme otra vez para Venezuela.
And there was plenty of times when it came to mind that I should have returned back to Venezuela.
Entonces venían personas me decían, ¿te volviste loco? ¿Cómo vas a dejar todo allá? ¿Por qué te vienes para acá?
There's a lot of people that will come to me and say, you're crazy. You left everything behind just to come here to the States.
Entonces ahí caí como Samuel, tenía una lucha en la mente, estaba quebrantado, estaba como desorientado.
And just like Samuel, I was having this mind, in mind battle of, you know, of in confusion of what should I have done.
Entonces yo llamo al Pastor Joaquín.
And I call Pastor Joaquín.
Porque necesito una reunión.
Because I needed to talk to him.
Entonces voy con mi esposa.
So I went to that meeting with my wife.
Aparte de todo, mis hijas me preguntaban, ¿por qué nos vinimos, papi?
And there's another important part of this is that my daughters will actually ask us and you know about what was going on.
Porque estábamos en una comodidad, en un confort, y nos movemos a donde no estábamos tan cómodos.
And the reason for all these conversations is because we used to be very, very comfortable and we actually moved into a place that wasn't as comfortable.
Yo le dije, solamente Dios sabe lo que tiene para nosotros.
And my answer to them in the questions was, only God knows what's best for us.
Pero yo me hacía la pregunta, ¿será que él lo hice bien?
But I will ask myself, did I got this right?
Entonces, cuando me reúno con el Pastor Joaquín,
so when I met with Pastor Joaquín,
bueno, en eso hay un tema político de los venezolanos, de la documentación. Entonces, yo de verdad estaba colapsado y bueno, fui a reunirme con el pastor.
So through this time, you know, we were having, as many of you know, there was a lot of issues with immigration, the status, the paperwork that we needed to do. And you know, I was just really, really confused and just overcome. So I had to have this meeting with Pastor Joaquín.
Entonces, Bishop Joaquín. Le cuento todo lo que siento, todo lo que sucede.
And I tell him everything that I was thinking, I was feeling.
Y él me dice, te voy a dar un consejo.
And Bishop Molina tells me, I'm going to give you an advice.
Me cuenta su historia cuando él abre el bufete de abogado.
So he shares with me his testimony about when he opened his legal firm.
Y dice, yo me sostuve por una palabra que Dios me dio.
And he told me that the way he was able to make it through is because of a word that God has given him.
Entonces, no piense en lo que estaba allá atrás en Venezuela.
So what Pastor Bishop Molina was telling me is, do not think about what's in the past in Venezuela.
Toma la palabra que te dio y camina.
Take the word and the promise he's giving you and move forward.
No lo asimilaba porque estaba en una situación difícil.
But for me, it was very hard to understand because I was going through a tough time.
Entonces el pastor dijo, vamos a orar.
And Bishop Molina said, let's pray.
Y Dios va a obrar.
And God is going to work on this.
Y efectivamente, tomé esa palabra que Dios me dio.
And just like that, I did accept it, that word that God has given me.
Y en el caminar, sentí mucha aflicción, pero Dios me dio la victoria.
And through the path, I did feel, you know, felt affliction, but God gave us the victory.
Pero si yo Amen. Me hubiese quedado como la esposa de Lot mirando atrás,
if I would have been like Lot's wife, that I was looking backwards,
o lamentándome de lo que pasó,
or lamenting for what I have left behind,
entonces no podemos cumplir el propósito que quiere Dios en nosotros. No nos estamos dejando Dios. Entramos en una pelea con Dios.
Then I was not going to be able to see what God has in the future or in front of me, and then I would have entered into a battle with God.
Vamos al siguiente versículo.
Let's move forward to the next verse, verse 4.
Hizo pues Samuel como le dijo Jehová, y luego que él llegó a Belén, los ancianos de la ciudad salieron a recibirle con miedo y dijeron, ¿es pacífica tu venida?
So verse 4 says, so Samuel did what the Lord said and went to Bethlehem. And the elders of the town trembled at his coming and said, do you come peacefully?
Hasta ahí llegué, dejé esa parte, ya él es obediente, ya él va a lo que Dios le mandó hacer.
So at this moment, Samuel is actually being obedient and submitting to God's will, and he's doing what God has told him to do.
Y toma ya el proyecto grande que tiene Dios, que es ungir a David.
And he takes over the project that the plan that God has, that it was actually to anoint David.
Y ya sabemos lo que pasa con David, el rey de Israel, y todas las promesas que Dios tenía para ellos.
And we know what the story tells us in the Bible, that then, you know, David becomes the king of Israel, and all the blessings that came for the people of Israel as part of this.
Podemos ir a 1 Samuel 2:8. Este es uno de los versículos que más me gusta.
Let's go to 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 8.
Él levanta del polvo al pobre, y del meludar exalta al menesteroso, para hacerle sentar con príncipe y heredar un sitio de honor. Porque de Jehová son las columnas de la tierra, y él afirmó sobre ellas el mundo.
1 Samuel, chapter 2, verse 8. It says, he raises the poor from the dust, and lifts the beggar from the ash heap, to set them among princes, and make them inherit the throne of glory. For the pillars of the earth are the Lord's, and he has said the word upon them.
Cuando nosotros estamos en un estado de, en lo más bajo, es la única forma de nosotros mirar hacia el cielo.
When we find ourselves in the lowest of states, and we're actually crumble all the way down, is the only chance that sometimes we get to actually look up towards heaven.
Dios tiene grandes cosas. El avivamiento que estaba hablando el pastor es lo que se está cocinando ahora.
So, you know, there's a lot of things that we can talk about, but one of the things I want to mention is the revival that Bishop was discussing this morning.
Tengo otro versículo.
There's another verse I want to share with you.
Que es Nehemías 2:17.
That's Nehemiah 2:17.
Vamos a ponerlo un momento. Okay. Les dijo pues, vosotros veis el mal en que estamos, que Jerusalén está desierta y sus puertas consumidas por el fuego. Venid y edifiquemos el muro de Jerusalén y no estemos más en oprobio.
So Nehemiah chapter 2 verse 17 says as follows. Then I said to them, you see the distress that we are in, how Jerusalem lies waste and its gates are burned with fire. Come and let us build the wall of Jerusalem, that we may no longer be a reproach.
Aquí está hablando Nehemías de levantar los muros de Jerusalén.
So here Nehemiah is actually discussing the process of how we're going to build or rebuild the walls of Israel, Jerusalem, sorry.
Entonces, el Señor me trae que, por ejemplo, la situación de que ahorita hubo una infestación de varias familias en la iglesia.
So, you know, what God brought to mind is this recent time when a lot of people, families at church, have been infected with the pandemic.
Podemos ver que de pronto fue un muro que cayó.
And we could see that this was actually a wall that went down.
Pero, ¿qué fue lo que se hizo?
But what happened?
Se levantaron los muros el día miércoles.
So, what happened was that actually in the day of Wednesday was when the walls were lifted.
Ya que se hizo un servicio de oración y clamar por aquellos que están quebrantados de salud.
And what happened was that we actually had a prayer service on Wednesday, and we started seeing the change, and our people of the church started to heal.
Y como estábamos diciendo esta mañana, las respuestas se han hecho sentir.
So like we were saying this morning, the response, the answers from God, now we're feeling them.
Por ejemplo, una de esas respuestas es mi esposa.
One of those answers is actually my wife.
Ella estaba positiva con COVID.
She actually hit positive to COVID.
Y ella se hizo la prueba ayer.
And yesterday she retested.
Y ya salió negativo.
And she's now negative.
Y hemos visto que varios hermanos ya salieron del hospital, otros han dado negativo, y hay una recuperación de parte de la iglesia.
So after the service, prayer service, we have seen that a lot of our people are continuing to recover. We have some brothers and sisters that were in the hospital, now they're home, recovering as well, and they're returning back to the church.
Pero si nos quedamos llorando de quién fue, cómo fue, y por dónde fue, no vamos a hacer la edificación de los muros.
But if we, you know, stay in the past trying to answer the five W's, we're not going to be able to look forward and rebuild the walls of the city.
Y nos estamos preparando para el día 8-8.
And we are actually getting ready this week for this upcoming event of 8-8-8.
Que Dios va a derramar de su unción a su pueblo.
And this is a time where we know God is going to pour a tremendous anointment on top of his people.
Entonces, lo que pasó con la familia, no hay que desanimarnos.
So if something happened to your family and something took place, do not be discouraged.
Tenemos que darnos ánimo unos a los otros para estar el 8-8 adorando a Dios.
We have to continue to encourage each other so we can be ready and get ready for this next event on 8-8-8.
Vamos al, seguimos en Nehemías, pero el 18.
So let's go to chapter 18, Nehemiah, the book of Nehemiah, but chapter 18.
Él tenía en su corazón levantar los muros.
He had in his heart to rebuild the walls of the city of Jerusalem.
Dios le dio una dirección y él la empezó a cumplir.
And Nehemiah received a mission from the Lord and he began to work on it.
En la mañana estaba hablando el obispo de ir a predicar el evangelio.
And Bishop was speaking about this morning about going and just preach the gospel.
Y tenemos que saber que tenemos que entender que en lo que estamos en los tiempos finales.
And we need to understand and very, very clear about this. We are on the final times.
Le voy a contar un testimonio que es poderoso.
So I want to share with you a powerful testimony.
Que es sobre la evangelización.
That is about evangelism.
Estaba hablando con un amigo allá en Venezuela.
And I was speaking to a friend of mine back in Venezuela.
Él se llama Carlos.
His name is Carlos.
De los Gedeones Internacionales.
He's from the International Gideons.
Entonces hubo una entrega en la cárcel de los Nuevos Testamentos, de los libritos azules que llaman.
And as you know, the Gideons have the mission when they take the New Testament, the little small blue book, and they deliver them from place to place. And in this specific case was to a jail, to a prison.
Entonces ellos tenían un mandato de Dios de ir y evangelizar y predicar el evangelio.
And the Gideons had this mandate from the Lord, and they felt they received, that was to go and preach the gospel to all nations.
Y entonces ocurrió algo muy particular allí.
And something very particular actually took place.
Entonces, cuando estaban entregando el Nuevo Testamento, le dijeron a uno, no le vas a entregar ese libro a él, a un reo.
During this process, one of the people, the staff, actually told somebody else, do not give the New Testament to this prisoner.
Y ellos le preguntan, ¿por qué no se lo vamos a entregar?
And, you know, and they ask, why can't we?
Porque ellos dicen que él agarraba las hojitas del libro.
And they say because he will take the pages of the book.
Y se la fumaba.
And he will smoke. He will smoke them.
Sí. Resourceful. Era su forma. Okay.
That was his way how to deal with stress, I guess.
Entonces, el Gedeón le dijo, mira, vamos a hacer algo. Dios me dice que te entregue el Nuevo Testamento.
So, the Gideon staff member, what he decided to do was, you know, listen, I'm going to make the decision, I'm going to give you the book.
Entonces le digo, bueno, tú te la vas a fumar.
And I know you're going to smoke it.
Pero cada vez que te vayas a fumar una hojita.
But before, the only thing I ask is before you actually smoke one of these pages.
Tú la tienes que leer.
You have to read it first.
Y él dijo, está bien.
And the prisoner said, okay, I'll do that.
Se fumó a Marco.
So he smoked the book of Mark.
Se fumó a Luca.
He smoked the whole book of Luke.
Pero cuando llegó a Juan, no se lo pudo fumar.
And when he got to the book of John, he couldn't smoke it.
Se arrepintió de corazón.
He was actually felt convicted and repented.
Sale en libertad.
He is now a free man.
Ahora él es un pastor.
And now he's a pastor. He's a preacher. Amen.
Pero si ese Gedeón no le entrega la Biblia a él.
But if that Gideon member, you know, man, wouldn't actually turn in and give this book, this New Testament to this man, this prisoner,
de pronto se estuviera fumando otra cosa ahorita.
Then maybe he would be smoking something else and still be in jail.
pero no se pudo fumar todos los evangelios.
But he couldn't smoke all the different books of the New Testament.
Entonces se restauraron los muros en la vida de ese hombre.
So on these men specifically, in his life, the wall of his life were restored.
Ustedes no tienen la idea de a dónde va a llegar una semilla que ustedes le den a alguien.
None of us has any idea or the smallest of the ideas on a seed that we're given and we've actually planted, how much that's going to grow and how far it's going to go.
Antes de venirme me pasó algo sumamente poderoso.
So before I came, something extremely powerful happened to me.
Ahí está amigo Carlos. El amigo Carlos.
Oh, my friend Carlos.
Me dice, vamos a hacer una campaña cerca de mi casa. Una campaña
let's say we're gonna go an evangelism campaign. Let's go and do one.
Entonces yo le dije, bueno, vamos a hacerla.
And I said, okay, let's go, let's do it.
Y entonces empezamos a acomodar las sillas, empezamos a organizar todo.
So we started to, you know, set up all the place, the chairs, the tables.
Y entonces viene un joven y me dice, pastor, yo te voy a ayudar.
And there was a young man who came to us and said, hey, I want to help.
Entonces yo lo miraba y yo dije, bueno, está bien.
And I looked at him and said, okay.
Él empezó a acomodar, empezó a ayudar.
So he started to arrange, you know, chairs and he started helping.
Empezamos la evangelización.
And we started the evangelism.
Él intervenía.
And he will intervene.
Pero él me miraba fijamente.
And he will look at me paying attention to me.
Yo decía, ¿en qué cárcel lo había conocido yo?
And then I was asking myself, in which prison I have met this young man before?
Bueno, termina la evangelización.
Well, the service ended.
Y él me llega.
And
me llegó.
And this young man approached me.
Y él me dice, ¿tú no te acuerdas de mí?
And he tells me, do you remember me?
Y dije, ay Dios.
And I was like, oh God.
Yo le dije, no me acuerdo de ti.
No, not really. I don't remember you.
Entonces, para que entienda lo que le voy a decir.
So you understand, I'll put it in perspective.
Un tiempo atrás había unos sitios en las comisarías que los estaban utilizando como cárceles.
So there was a long time ago where at the police stations they were using the actual police stations as a jail, as a prison.
Entonces estábamos en la oración y yo dije, si alguno de ustedes quiere que yo ore por usted, pasa adelante.
And during the process of evangelist service that we had, I actually said, hey, if any of you wants to be prayed for, please step forward.
Y entonces este señor viene, un moreno alto, doble.
And this man who was a black man, and he was big and just huge, tremendous size.
Y me dice, yo quiero que ores por mí.
And he tells me, I want you to pray for me.
Y yo le dije, ¿por qué estás aquí condenado?
And I ask him, what is that, the reason that you're here in jail?
Me dice, porque me agarraron atracando en la moto.
Because they catch me doing something that was pretty bad.
Yo oré por él.
And I pray for him.
Él se quebranta.
And I, he was broken.
Me abraza.
He hugged me.
Y yo me voy.
And then I left.
Cuando estábamos en la evangelización.
When we were actually in the service that we were talking before.
Era ese moreno.
It was that man.
Y me dice, gracias a ese día.
And he told me, thanks to that day.
Que acepté al Señor en mi corazón.
That I accepted Jesus Christ in my heart.
Me dieron una salida condicional.
They put me in parole.
Conseguí a mi esposa. Me presentó a la esposa.
I met my wife and I have a wife.
Tengo
and
un
he
hogar.
Introduced a wife to me.
Tengo un hogar.
I have a home.
Y dejé de ser un ladrón.
And I stopped being a thief.
Ahora soy un hombre de Dios.
And now I'm a man of God. Amen. Amen.
Entonces, no nos imaginamos la trascendencia que pueda tener una palabra en alguien.
So, you know, many of us can't really appreciate or don't appreciate how much is going to transcend a seed that we plant in someone.
Como el Obispo Boone dijo, tú tienes la palabra hoy.
So Bishop Boone was saying this morning that we have the word today.
Yo no puedo ir a tu trabajo, pero tú sí puedes ir a mi trabajo, tú vas a tu trabajo.
So and we have the word, we actually own the word, and Bishop can, or us, we can go to your job, but you are at your workplace.
Y tú predicas en tu trabajo.
And you should be preaching the gospel in your job.
Y ellos van a predicar en su familia.
And then they will preach to their families.
Y la semilla va a ser regada.
And then the seed is going to be spread throughout.
Y el Señor va a dar el crecimiento.
And God is going to be the one who's going to make it grow.
Vamos al siguiente versículo.
Let's go to the next verse on Nehemiah.
Pero cuando lo oyeron, Sanbalat, Oronita, Tobías, el siervo amonita, y Gesem, el árabe, hicieron escarnio de nosotros y nos despreciaron, diciendo, ¿qué es lo que hacéis vosotros? Os rebeláis contra el rey.
Verse 19, but when Sanbalat, the Horonite, Tobiah, the Ammonite official, and Geshem, the Arab, heard of it, they laughed at us and despised us and said, "What is this thing that you are doing? Will you rebel against the king?"
Siempre va a haber gente que va a cuestionar lo que estamos haciendo.
There's a lot of people. There's always going to be people who's going to be questioning what we do.
Pero eso no va a hacer que nosotros nos desanimemos.
But that should not be the reason why we get discouraged.
Hay que seguir en la comisión que Dios nos ha dado.
We gotta continue fulfilling the commission that God has given us.
Yo, por ejemplo, tengo un sobrino.
For example, I have a nephew.
Él es el mayor de mi sobrino.
He is the oldest of my nephews.
Cuando él estaba como de 9 años, más o menos.
When he was about 9 years old.
Tuvimos la oportunidad de compartir con él un buen tiempo.
We had a time where we were able to just share life with him.
Y en una de esas reuniones.
In one of these meetings that we had.
Él aceptó al Señor.
He accepted Jesus.
Él oraba con nosotros.
He used to pray with us.
Y quedó esa semilla en él allí.
And that seed was planted in his heart.
Ahora él tiene 21 años.
Now he's a 21-year-old young man.
Ahora es líder en una iglesia.
Now he's a leader at his church.
Y es una iglesia en la cual él está llevando un testimonio.
And this is a church when he's actually bringing testimony to the church.
Lo importante de los niños cuando están allá en la escuela dominical.
So this is a very important thing when we talk about the children being at the Bible school.
Que no sabemos a dónde va a llegar esa semilla.
And we have no idea until how far that seed is going to go.
O por ejemplo conmigo.
Or for example myself.
Si la pastora que me predicó a mí el evangelio.
If the pastor who preached to me the gospel.
No me hubiese hablado, no estuviera aquí.
Haven't preached it to me, then there's no way I was going to be here tonight.
No creo que hubiese tenido otro accidente en otro bus, no creo. Otro accidente en el bus.
I wouldn't have another accident at the bus.
Así me dijo un amigo, tranquilo Juan, no hemos visto en la estadística que dos personas se estrellen en otro bus.
And he was told by a friend, hey, don't worry about it, there is no statistics, there's no data that two people will crash in the same bus.
Yo le dije, no quiero estar en esa estadística.
And he said, well, I truly don't want to be part of the statistics.
Pero también yo me acuerdo.
But I also remember.
Que cuando estaba yo en la santería.
Then I used to be on witchcraft.
Mi esposa le dijo a una sierva del Señor.
My wife talked to a lady that was a servant of God.
Mi esposa tenía la inquietud porque sabía que eso no estaba bien.
My wife knew that witchcraft was not a good thing. She was uncomfortable with it.
Y le pidió que orara por mí.
And she asked this lady to pray for me.
Y ella dijo que no.
And she said, no, I won't.
Porque Dios no he sentido autorización de parte de Dios de ir para allá.
And the reason that she gave my wife not to pray for me was because she has not felt the authorization or the conviction from the Lord to do this.
¿Qué quiere decir esto?
What does this mean?
Que si tú no predicas, va a venir otro.
That if you don't preach, somebody else will.
Entonces, tenemos que predicar el evangelio.
So it's not for us to decide. We have to preach the gospel.
El cristiano pasa muchas situaciones.
So Christians, we go through a lot of different situations.
Y preguntamos por qué nos pasan estas situaciones.
And sometimes we ask ourselves, why do we go through these situations?
Porque es el testimonio que le vamos a dar a otro del poder de Dios.
And I can tell you right now, the reason is because this is the testimony that we're going to be able to share with somebody else in the future.
Vamos al otro versículo.
Let's go to the next verse.
Cuando él oye esto, Nehemías, él le da esta respuesta.
So when Nehemiah hears this mockering that these other people was doing against him, he gives them this response right here in verse 20.
Y en respuesta le dijo, el Dios de los cielos, él nos proveerá y nosotros sus siervos nos levantaremos y edificaremos, porque vosotros no tenéis parte ni derecho ni memoria en Jerusalén.
And Nehemiah gives them the very strong answer. He says, so I answered to them and I said to them, the God of heaven himself will prosper us. Therefore, we, his servants, will arise and build. But you have no heritage or right or memorial in Jerusalem.
Muchas veces el pasado que nosotros vivimos.
Many times the past that we have lived.
Quiere determinar nuestro futuro.
Wants to take over and determine our future.
Y eso no es así.
And that's not the way this works.
Porque Dios marcó una nueva senda para cada uno de nosotros.
Because for those who have accepted Christ, God has marked a new path for all of us.
Porque muchas veces dirán, si yo venía de la santería, ¿qué me van a creer a mí?
Because sometimes I could have think, hey, if I was in witchcraft, then who's going to believe me?
O muchos que han salido de la cárcel dicen, ya que salí de la cárcel, ahora quién me va a creer que yo he sido transformado.
We have other people that have been in jail, and then when you come out, you know, who's going to believe that you actually have been transformed by the Holy Spirit?
Pero lo nuevo que hizo Dios es lo que va a hacer que la gente crea en el Señor.
But that's what the power of God is, that God is going to make people believe.
A mí me pasó algo esta semana.
Something happened to me this week.
Que de verdad quedé pensativo.
That made me think about a lot of things.
Yo voy pasando por un sitio.
I was going through a place.
Y veo una señora que está saliendo de un centro oncológico.
And I see a lady that is coming out of an oncologist.
Entonces yo me paro.
And I stopped.
Y le digo, ¿cómo está, señora?
And I ask her, hey ma'am, how are you?
¿Cómo se siente?
How do you feel?
Y ella me dice, te podrás imaginar, 4 horas de quimioterapia.
And she said, well, can you imagine 4 hours of chemotherapy?
No estaba dispuesta a recibir nada.
And she was not willing to receive anything.
Yo le dije, yo te entiendo.
And I said, I understand.
Ella en su mente pudo haber dicho, ¿qué me va a entender él? Pero yo sí lo entiendo porque mi madre murió de cáncer.
In her mind, she could be thinking, you know, who is this guy telling me that I understand? What she didn't know was that my mom actually died of cancer.
Claro, no le iba a decir eso porque no le iba a dar ánimo.
But I was not going to tell her that and share that testimony because it's not going to be encouraging for her.
Entonces me puse a hablar con ella y una de las cosas que ella me dice, yo ya he vivido mucho, yo ya tengo 79 años, me dice.
So we started having a conversation back and forth, and one of the things that she shared with me is, hey, I'm 79 years old, I have lived enough.
Entonces ella veía como inútil hacerse la quimioterapia.
So she felt that having this chemotherapy was actually something that was a waste of time.
Entonces yo le dije, ¿por qué es inútil?
And I asked her, what do you think is a waste?
¿Tú tienes hijo?
Do you have children?
Sí.
And she said, yes.
¿Tú tienes nieto?
Do you have grandkids?
Entonces, ¿por qué tú no quieres disfrutar de tus hijos y tus nietos unos años más?
So when I asked her, you have children and you have, you know, grandkids, she said, yes. And I said, well, why don't you want to enjoy your children and your grandchildren for a longer period of time?
Yo le dije, ¿por qué no quieres luchar?
Why is the reason that you don't want to fight?
No veo ningún motivo por luchar.
And she said, I see no reason for me to fight this.
Yo le dije, te voy a presentar a alguien.
And I said, well, I'm going to introduce you to someone.
Se llama Jesucristo.
And his name is Jesus.
¿Tú quieres que ore por ti?
Do you want me to pray for you?
Y me dijo, sí, quiero que ore.
And she said, yes, I want you to pray for me.
Oré por ella.
I prayed for her.
Se quebrantó.
She was broken.
Hicimos la oración de fe.
We pray the salvation prayer.
Y ella dijo, ahora sí quiero vivir.
And now she said, at the end of the prayer, now I want to live.
Amen. Un minuto de diferencia.
1 minute. It took 1 minute.
No quiero vivir.
From saying, I don't want to live.
Al minuto.
To another minute.
Quiero vivir.
Yes, I want to live.
Porque Cristo es vida.
Because Jesus is life. Amen.
Pero a veces pasamos indiferentes por las cosas.
But sometimes, you know, we take things for granted.
Y esa persona se pudo haber muerto sin Cristo.
And that person, I could have just keep driving, and that person could have just died without knowing Jesus.
Si parte, ya va con Cristo.
But if now it happens that she dies, then she will be with the Lord.
Pero ya hay una motivación de que las quimioterapias tienen un sentido.
But now this chemotherapy that she's receiving also have a new meaning for her.
Entonces estamos para levantar los muros caídos.
So we are there also to lift, to rebuild the walls that have been destroyed.
Guiados por el Señor.
Always guided by the Lord.
Vamos al siguiente versículo.
Let's go to the next verse.
El 20.
Nehemías.
No, está ahí. Vamos a hablar de esto ahí.
We're going to leave it right there.
Ahora vamos a poner Salmo 37:24.
We're going to go to Psalms 37:24.
Hay una experiencia que de verdad cada vez que la cuento me impacta.
There is an experience a situation that I have that every single time I share it's just very impactful for me.
Porque muchas veces que creemos en la situación que estamos, no vamos a surgir ni vamos a salir adelante.
And it is that, you know, many of us, we go through these situations and sometimes we really get to think and believe that we're not going to overcome.
Una vez estábamos en el retén, en Maracaibo. Retén.
So there was a time when I was actually in jail.
Entonces, hay un muchacho que estaba deprimido.
There was a kid that was depressed.
Entonces yo le dije, una de las cosas que te tiene deprimido es lo que tienes en la mano.
And one of the things that I told him was, hey, listen, one of the things that have you so depressed is exactly what you're carrying in your hand.
Practicaba la santería.
And he was, what happens, he was practicing witchcraft.
Entonces yo le dije, quítate eso.
And I told him, take that off.
¿Tú crees que me va a ayudar?
Do you think it's going to help?
Estoy seguro.
And I told him, of course.
Entonces él se quitó la manilla.
So he took this bracelet that witchcraft people uses or wears.
Y sacó todo lo que tenía en el cuarto de imágenes, del EY, todo eso.
And he decided to take and remove all images and all kind of, you know, equipment that he had that represented witchcraft.
Cuando voy saliendo de la cárcel,
when I was departing the jail,
me llaman, me paran y me llaman.
Someone called me and they stopped me.
Yo dije, aquí hay problema.
And I said, okay, there's troubles in here.
Entonces voy para allá.
So I started walking that way.
Y hay otro moreno.
There's another black man over there standing.
Con un arma en la mesa.
With a weapon, with a gun on the table.
Yo dije, estoy en problema.
And I said, okay, I'm in trouble now.
Yo le dije, ¿qué pasó?
And I said, okay, what happened?
Él me dice, ¿tú por qué mandas a sacar esas cosas de nuestro cuarto? ¿Qué es lo que nos protege?
And he challenged me and asked me why I was telling these other men, these other young men, to remove this witchcraft stuff from a room. And he then told me, these are the things that protect us.
Yo le dije, porque yo vengo de ese mundo y ese mundo no trae paz.
And my answer to him was, because I come from that word and I know that does not bring peace.
Entonces él me dice, aquí en la cárcel hay otra ley.
And he tells me, here in jail, there's a different law.
Yo lo entiendo.
And I said, I understand.
Pero Dios es el que manda.
But I tell you right now, God is in charge.
Entonces él me dice, vamos a hacer un trato.
So he tells me, let's make a deal.
Dale.
And I say, okay, let's go.
Me dice, yo voy a tener esta cosa aquí encima.
And he tells me, I'm going to be wearing this bracelet.
Y en una semana vamos a hablar.
In 1 week, let's talk again.
Yo le dije, pero dale una oportunidad a Dios.
But I told him, however, you need to give a chance to God.
Y en una semana hablamos.
And in 1 week, we'll talk.
Yo creo que me demoré como 15 días en ir otra vez.
And I think it actually took me about 2 weeks to head back.
Y cuando yo llego.
And when I get back to the jail.
Se me olvidó lo que yo había hablado con él.
I completely have forgotten what I've spoken to this man.
Apenas llegué, me recibió.
And as soon as I got there, he actually came out and received me.
De inmediato me recordé.
And immediately when I saw him, I remembered what we have talked.
Me dice, Pastor, necesito hablar contigo.
And I said, Pastor, we need to talk.
Y dice, Señor, recibe mi alma.
And I said, Lord, please protect me.
Entonces nos sentamos.
And we went ahead and I said, we sat down.
Él pone el arma.
He placed the gun again on the table.
Yo le dije, ¿qué pasó?
And I said, okay, what's the deal?
Tú tienes razón.
And he said, you were right.
Te entrego esto, que esto no da paz.
I want to give you all this stuff. This does not bring peace.
Y él me dijo, a partir de hoy.
And he said, from now on.
Quiero que me enseñes de la palabra.
I want you to teach me about the gospel.
Y hice una afinidad con él.
And I developed an amazing relationship with this man.
Que éramos amigos.
And we became friends.
Él a veces mandaba motos a la calle para que me siguiera.
And he would actually send people on motorcycles to follow me.
Yo le dije, yo no necesito que me siga.
And I told him, listen, I don't need anyone to follow me, to protect me.
Me dice, Pastor, una ayudita.
And he's like, hey, Pastor, don't worry, you know, a little help is good.
Iban a la iglesia, se sentaban. Lo bueno es que ellos escuchaban la palabra.
And they will come, you know, to the services and they will listen to the gospel.
Pero aquí viene la parte triste.
But here comes the sad part of all this.
Ahí lo trasladan a otra cárcel. Lo trasladan a otra cárcel.
He got transferred to another prison.
Y yo voy a visitarlo allá.
And I go to visit him over there.
Porque era mi amigo.
Because he was my friend.
Y yo le dije, hermano.
And I said, brother.
Cristo viene pronto.
Jesus Christ is coming soon.
Entonces él me dijo, te voy a confesar algo.
And he told me, I want to confess something to you.
Me da pena dejar las armas. Me da pena dejar las armas.
It's tough for me to actually leave, you know, not have guns anymore, not to deal with guns anymore.
Porque aquí el más fuerte es el que manda.
Because here in jail, the strongest is the only one who survives and is in charge.
Yo le dije, confía en el Señor.
And I told him, you need to trust God.
Me dice, vamos a hacer algo.
And he says, let's make a deal, another deal.
Tú eres mi hermano.
You're my brother.
La semana que viene.
Next week.
Dejo las armas.
I will stop dealing with weapons.
Y le sirvo al Señor.
And I will serve God with all my heart.
Hubo un motín y lo mataron.
There was a riot at the jail, and he was killed. He was murdered.
Y me siente. Me siente.
And that hurts me. Still, it hurts me.
Porque no es el tiempo de nosotros.
Because it's not our time.
Dios dijo ya.
God said enough.
El domingo yo lo iba, el sábado lo iba a visitar.
Next Saturday I was going to go and see him.
Y el viernes lo mataron.
And on Friday, the day before, is when he was murdered. He was killed in jail.
No hay tiempo.
There's no time.
En cualquier momento nos vamos.
Any time could be the time when we taken.
Mucha, a veces nos llenamos de información.
A lot of times we fill ourselves with information.
Tú le preguntas a alguien sobre el COVID.
And you ask someone, for example, about COVID.
Sí, en tantos días tienen la inmunidad, te da problemas respiratorios. Prácticamente somos médicos.
And you listen to the people, and it seems like they almost sound like doctors. You know, they give you all the symptoms, all the whys, the five W's about the situation.
Ah, te sientes mal, toma Tylenol, toma esto, toma aquello.
And then even people that are not doctors, anyone on the street, they start prescribing you, hey, drink the Tylenol, you know, hydrate, rest. And they sound like doctors.
Y digo, ajá, ¿y cuántas veces has leído la Biblia?
And then I told them, let me ask you something. How many times you actually have read the Bible?
No sé.
There's silence.
I don't know. Nos llenamos de cierta cosa. Es bueno saber del COVID.
So, you know, we fill ourselves with information, for example, this that we're talking about COVID.
Pero es más importante saber la palabra para que podamos darle a la gente que tiene
Amen.
COVID.
But it's more important for us to know about the Bible and the gospel so we can share that message with the people who has it, doesn't have COVID, anyone.
Entonces, una de las cosas que Dios me traía es que cuando tú decides obrar y guiarte por el Dios, hay una mano sobrenatural encima de ti que se mueven las cosas.
And what I want to share with you is when you make the decision, you decide to move in accordance with God's plans, there is an amazing hand that moves from place to place and guides you to do the things that God wants you to do and just blesses you.
Yo, por ejemplo, puedo hablar del Pastor Oscar.
And for example, I'm going to show you something about Pastor Oscar.
Cuando estábamos los dos hablando, que me dio la bienvenida.
When he welcomed me.
La bienvenida.
When he welcomed me.
No, yo le he perdonado, no crean que no le he perdonado.
And let me tell you, I have forgiven him.
Él tenía una gracia para decírmelo.
He has a tremendous grace to tell me things.
Fue duro.
He was tough.
Pero tuvo la gracia.
But he had grace.
Dios lo mandó a que dijera eso.
God actually led him to say the things that he told me.
No dijo más, ni dijo menos.
He didn't say more, he didn't say less.
Porque yo me hubiese podido exaltar.
Because I could have been offended.
Bueno, hubiese podido pelear, pero sabía que me iba a ganar.
¿Sí? Well, I could have maybe picked up a fight, but I know Pastor Oscar would have beat me down.
Lo sé ahora, en aquel momento no lo sabía.
Well, I definitely know that now. I didn't know that in that moment.
Pero tuvo la gracia de decirme lo que yo estaba fallando.
But he had the bravery, but also the grace to tell me the things on what I needed to improve because I was failing.
Pero es la gracia que Dios colocó en él.
But it's that grace that God has placed upon him.
Pero si yo intento imitar eso.
But if I try to do the same thing and imitate that.
Termino agarrándome los puños.
Then most likely I'll end up in a fight.
O quiero, por ejemplo, la gracia que tiene José para ministrar en el teclado.
Or for example, you know, our brother Joshua Molina, Josué Molina. His grace, the talent that he has with worship and playing the piano.
Es lo que Dios ha colocado en él.
That's what God has given him. That's a gift.
Entonces vamos a leer el Salmo.
So let's read Psalms 37:24.
Cuando el hombre cayere, no quedará postrado, porque el Señor sostiene su mano.
Verse 24. Though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, for the Lord upholds him with his hand. Amen.
Ahí en Nehemías, él estaba hablando con todos los líderes, diciendo que Dios en su mano poderosa lo llevó allí para que edificaran los muros.
And you remember we're going back to Nehemiah, when Nehemiah was telling all the leaders that God himself had brought him to the city so he could work and rebuild the walls of Jerusalem.
Cuando hablé con el Pastor Joaquín,
when I spoke with Bishop Molina,
y me dijo, lo que te va a sostener es la mano de Dios.
What is going to support you and guide you is that this God hands his hand.
Lo que nos sostiene es la mano de Dios.
And what is going to take care of you is God's hand.
No vamos a quedar postrados.
We're not going to be at fault.
Dios pone la prueba a cada uno que pueda superar.
And God is going to put tests, he's going to test you, but only on the test that you will be able to overcome.
Ahorita estaba recordando con este salmo.
I was remembering about, you know, I was thinking about this psalm.
Un amigo allá en Venezuela.
And a friend back home in Venezuela.
Él se llama Tito.
His name is Tito.
Y él perdió su primer bebé.
And he lost his first baby.
Y él entendió que fue de parte de Dios.
And Tito got to understand that happened because that was part of God's plan in his life.
Él no se quedó postrado.
He was not at fault. He didn't let himself down.
Dios le habló y le dijo, te voy a dar otro hijo.
And God spoke to him and said, I'm going to give you another son.
Y actualmente él tiene una princesa.
And right now he actually has a daughter.
Pero si él se hubiese quedado.
But if he would have just stayed in that season.
Pasan los años.
Years will pass
y no hubiese tenido su hija.
And he wouldn't have another children, in this case his daughter.
Se limpió, se levantó y siguió.
He was cleansed, he stood up, he kept going, moving forward, and he was restored.
Vamos a ir a Salmo 104:28.
Let's go to Psalms 104, verse 20.
Tengo muchas experiencias que hemos vivido tanto en las cárceles como en las campañas.
There's many experiences that we have lived through, you know, also in, you know, evangelism campaigns, but also in when we do services in prisons, different jails.
Yo estaba leyendo en el libro de Esdras, en el capítulo 7, 9 y 10.
And I was reading the Esdras, a book on chapter 9 and 10.
Que cuando Esdras pudo aceptar lo que Dios le dijo, pudo poner por obra lo que Dios le dijo, él hace referencia allí que la mano de Dios lo acompañó y lo bendijo.
And what is shared here in the story in the Bible is that when he accepted God to be in control, there was a hand of God moving and leading every single thing in his life.
La mano de Dios está sobre nosotros.
God's hands is upon us.
Era para que desde que empezó la pandemia todos nos hubiésemos infectado.
And this is, you know, one thing that I continue to think is when the pandemic started, we all should have gotten sick.
Pero vino ahora.
But it actually came to this time.
Un pequeño lote.
It was a little, you know, a little group of our church who actually got ill.
Pero ya se ve la recuperación.
But we've seen everyone recovering.
Y en un par de semanas estaremos juntos adorando a Dios.
And in a couple of weeks, I know that we're all going to be back home here worshiping the Lord. Amen.
Pongamos el Salmo 104:28. Por favor.
So let's go to Psalm 4, verse 28.
Les da, recogen. Abren tus manos, se saciarán de bien.
So Psalm 104:28 says, what you give them, they gather in. You open your hand, they are filled with good.
Tenemos que abrir nuestras manos para lo que Dios va a darnos a cada uno de nosotros.
We have to open our hands so we can receive what God has for us.
Nosotros en nuestra mente finita creemos que Dios está limitado.
In our limited minds, we think that God himself is limited.
Pero Dios no está limitado.
But God is not limited.
Es ilimitado.
He's unlimited.
Abre tus manos y recibe lo que Dios tiene para ti.
Open your hands and receive what God has for you tonight.
Cada quien sabe en qué Dios le está dando órdenes a seguir y corregir.
God speaks to us individually, and we know what God is telling us to do.
Muchas veces, estaba hablando yo con el pastor, que muchas veces la gente no viene a hablar con él.
I was speaking with Bishop Molina, and we were sharing that a lot of people doesn't come to speak to him, or to talk to him,
o con ningún pastor,
or with any pastor at all.
Porque ellos han trazado su camino.
Because the pastor...
Han trazado, la gente trazó su camino.
Okay, so the people has developed their own path, their own idea of their path.
Y no quieren que sea otro camino.
And they don't want to change that path.
Y por lo general te dicen, ve para otro lado.
And for the most part, the pastors, when they speak to you, they will tell you, you're being disobedient and you have to move into this direction.
Entonces, tienen que pedir un consejo y estar en búsqueda del Señor.
So for you to receive this, you have to be willing to receive the advice and actually seeking for the Lord.
Para que la mano de Dios esté ahí sobre ti.
So God's hand can be upon you and cover you.
Vamos a poner el último versículo, Juan 10:28, es una promesa.
Let's go to our last chapter here tonight, our last verse, which is on John chapter 10, verse 28.
Y yo les doy vida eterna. No perecerán jamás y nadie les arrebatará de mi mano.
So this is a beautiful promise in verse 28 of John 10. It tells us, and I give them the eternal life and they shall never perish. Neither shall anyone snatch them out of my hand.
Hay miles promesas para cada uno de nosotros.
There are thousands of promises for every single one of us.
Pero tenemos vida juntamente con Cristo.
But we have life conjointly with Jesus.
Y los que somos de él no vamos a ser arrebatados de su mano.
And those that belong to him will never be snatched.
Pero tenemos que afirmarnos en su palabra.
But we have to be reaffirmed in his promises and his word.
Puede ser algún familiar que necesita que se entregue al Señor.
It could be one of our family members who needs to accept Jesus Christ.
O no sé en qué área Dios está trabajando en ti.
Or maybe, I mean, I'm not sure exactly in which aspect of your life God is working on you.
Pero mucha gente le digo esto.
But I tell this to a lot of people.
Has intentado mil cosas.
You have tried many, many things.
Intenta con Dios.
Try Jesus. Try God.
Es lo único que les puedo decir.
It's the only thing I can tell you.
Que van a tener respuestas.
That you will find answers.
No quiero decir que se te van a acabar los problemas, que no vas a sufrir más, que todo va a ser un cuento de mil maravillas. No estoy diciendo eso.
And I'm not saying that when you come to Jesus, you know, at first, everything is going to go away, your troubles will be over, and you're not going to have afflictions.
Pero sabemos que, en quién creemos y a dónde vamos a ir.
But now we know on who we have believed and where we're heading.
Yo estaba haciendo un curso.
I was actually studying a course.
Y el profesor no quiere nada con Dios.
And the professor that was teaching the course wanted nothing to do with God.
Y él hizo una pregunta.
And he asked a question.
Porque yo le dije que yo era cristiano.
Because I told him I was a Christian.
Él dice, ¿acaso los cristianos no tienen problema?
And he said, well, isn't it true that Christians don't have problems?
¿O dónde está Dios cuando el cristiano tiene problema?
Or where is God when Christians have problems?
Yo le dije, en el libro de Romanos dice que nada nos va a separar del amor de Cristo.
And I told him that the book of Romans and the Bible tells us that nothing will separate us from God.
Y que vamos a tener tribulaciones.
And that we will have afflictions.
Pero él va a estar con nosotros.
But he will be with us.
Yo le dije, ¿y tú qué vas a hacer cuando tengas problemas?
And I asked him, what about you? What are you going to do when you have problems?
¿A quién vas a pedir socorro?
Who are you going to go and seek for help?
Se quedó en silencio.
And he was quiet, in silence.
Y nunca más me habló.
And we never talk again.
Se puso bravo.
He was upset.
Pero era mi deber.
But it was my
mi deber.
My duty to say something about this.
Entonces debemos de hablar, levantar los muros y sabemos que Dios nos va a levantar también.
And we need to know that our mission is to build these walls and God will take care of us.
Vamos a orar.
Let's pray tonight.
Para que el Señor sea dándole crecimiento a esa semilla.
So God now takes the seed and continues to grow it in our lives.
Padre, te damos gracias por esta palabra.
Father, we thank you for this word tonight.
Te damos gracias por tu presencia.
We thank you for your presence.
Bendice a cada uno de los que han escuchado.
Bless every single one of the people who have listened to this word tonight.
Ha caído en buena tierra.
It has fallen in tremendous good soil.
Va a dar frutos al mil por uno.
It's going to prosper 1,000 for 1.
Permite, Señor.
Allow, oh Jesus.
Que puedan tener una comunión contigo.
That we all can have a tremendous communion with you.
Y respóndele, Señor.
And respond to this.
En el nombre poderoso de Jesús.
In the name, powerful name of Jesus.
Te damos gracias, Padre.
We thank you, oh Father.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Amén.
Amen, amen.
Bueno, están despedidos.
Well, tonight, this concludes our service.
Mañana por la noche, reunión de hombres.
Tomorrow night, we have our men's meeting.
El miércoles igual hay servicio aquí.
And like we mentioned, the following service is also throughout the week on Wednesday.
Y estén pendientes para los restos de los anuncios.
And continue to pay attention to our updates to our Facebook page and online.
Y no se pierdan el 8-8.
And do not miss the next big event of 8-8-8.
Algo poderoso va a suceder allí.
Something tremendous and powerful is going to happen here.
Los bendigo en el nombre del Señor.
God bless you all.
Amén.